Numericals on equilibrium of beams. Determine the support reaction for the beam loaded and supported as shown in figure. In this figure, beam AB is supported. At joint A, there is a hinge support. So two reactions, HA and VA. At joint B, roller support. So one reaction, RB, perpendicular to the plane of the roller. Now here there is a uniformly distributed load UDL of 20 kN per meter acting over 2 meter span. Convert it into point load, which is equal to 20 into 2 equal to 40 kN. It will act at the center of the spread in this format, which is shown in the free wall diagram. Here inclined force 15 kN is resolved into its component 15 cos 60. 15 sin 60. In order to find out reactions at A and B, apply condition of equilibrium. Summation Fx equal to 0. Assumption, forces towards right positive, forces towards left negative. So here plus HA minus 15 cos 60. Degree equal to 0. Therefore HA is equal to 7.5 kN. Positive value means our assumption HA towards right is correct. Summation FY equal to 0. Assumption is forces upward are positive, forces downward are negative. Plus VA plus 12 minus 40 minus 15 sin 60 degree plus RB equal to 0. There are two unknowns, VA and RB, so we'll solve it afterwards. It is equation 1. Third condition of equilibrium, summation movement of all forces about point A equal to 0. Clockwise movements are positive, anti-clockwise moments are taken negative. So movement of all forces about point A is taken. This 12 kN. It is acting at perpendicular distance 2 from A. So 12 into 2. It is going to create anti-clockwise moment about A. So minus 40. It is acting at distance 2, 3 and 4 meters. It is going to create clockwise movement about point A. So plus 15 sin 60. It is acting at a distance of 6 meters. And it is going to create clockwise movement about point A. 15 cos 60. Line of action passes through A. So its movement is not taken. RB is acting at distance of 8 meter and it is going to create anti-clockwise movement of AB about point A. So minus equal to 0. Here there is only one unknown, RB. So we get value of RB, which is equal to 26.74 kN. Positive value means our assumption RB acting upward is correct. Now from equation 1. We'll get value of VA by putting value of RB. So from 1 we get value of VA, which is equal to 14.26 kN. Positive value means our assumption VA acting upward is correct. Now we want reaction RA. So reaction RA is equal to under root HA square plus VA square. We'll put value of HA and VA. HA is 7.5 square plus VA is 14.26 square. We get value of RA, which is equal to 16.11 kN. We want to know what is the angle made by this final RA with respect to horizontal. So theta A is angle made by RA with respect to horizontal. Theta A is taken equal to tan inverse VA upon HA. So here tan inverse VA value is 14.26, HA value is 7.5. We get value of theta A, which is equal to 62.26 degree with respect to HA, means horizontal. So finally we can write down value of RA, which is equal to 16.11 kilonewton at theta A equal to 62.26 degree. Now since HA, VA are positive, RA lies in first quadrant, and value of RB, which we have calculated, equals to 26.74 kilonewton, and it is acting vertically upward.